before you came into the consciousness of Nigerians.
Yes.
What was it like, and how did that focus your mind with regards to what needed to be done in this environment?
Okay, so the
as
first,
far as journalism went.
Yeah, so the first thing with the BBC is that it's a massive school of journalism. Why? Because, you know, they do radio, they do TV, they do magazines, and they have a process where in-house, if you were up to it and you didn't mind competing, you could actually move from department to department. So outside my primary work of radio, I did spend a bit of time doing what they call attachments, which is sort of working in different parts of the BBC in newsrooms. The first thing it taught me was resilience, because there were times when I was in the BBC newsroom where I literally stand up and look, I'm the only black person, I'm the only one. You know, so that's the first thing, learning to sort of live in a space in which you were not, you were different. So resilience, you know, that sort of thing. But it also, I think, despite the fact that the BBC being, you know, empire and colonialism, it does have certain standards when it comes to sort of journalism. You imbibe those, you learn those things. But it was also actually, after a while, a very depressing place to work. Because you found yourself years, because my speciality was Africa. And so we covered Rwanda, we covered the genocide, we did, you know, DR Congo, Sierra Leone, Liberia. And after a while, it became really depressed. Because it was like, we were just the same stories every year and nothing was changing. One of the reasons I left was I had a bit of a burnout at some point, and I got sort of a little bit, I became very negative about things, and I decided to take a step back, and I kind of left for a little while before coming back to journalism. But the BBC is significant in my life and in my career, and in helping me sort of decide that this is what I want to do, and I want to be able to come here and see if I can replicate the same kind of public-oriented, public service type of journalism. So I think it's every country needs that.
Yes.
Not that the BBC is that anymore, I'm not sure it is, but you know, that's another story.
So given this burnout that you've touched upon, return to Nigeria was inevitable, wasn't it?
I think so, and particularly